Hi everyone, I'm Chamo Yang from INTI International University, who is currently studying the course of Diploma in Mass Communication, and this was my second semester. We're having a hard time at the moment during this pandemic period. Many people suffer from it, losing their jobs or not enough salary and incomes to survive it. I always tell myself, in order to survive this, I need to have a great financial management in order to have enough savings to survive this kind of situation in the future. I was once a person who did not manage my savings well, as I was addicted in playing mobile games called The Honor of Kings, playing from morning until night. I spent lots of my savings into the game non-stop to buy all of the beautiful game skins and weapons in the game. I even sneak into my parents' wallets to take some cash without letting them notice about it. I am not stopping to waste money. What I do is I buy whatever I like in Lazada, Shopee, or Taobao. Anything I think is cool or useful. In the end, I wasted all of the things I bought without using them for such a long time. Or I broke it. One day, I realized I spent all my savings until it became 3 ringgit and 50 cents. My parents started to realize their money was gone. I still remember that I get scolded by my mom as she was really frustrated about it. On that day, I lie down on bed, start to think, what is my problem? What are some people who could use up their money and bankrupt? What are some people who has a high income? They could still finish all their money in a short period. And why all of us should have savings? People work hard for their job, doing food delivery, rushing to the location to deliver food to the consumer, taking the risk of their life. People working under the sun. It is tough, but they do it to earn money as much as they could for their family. I realized money is not easy to earn nowadays. I decided to apologize to my parents, and then I saw they were still working overtime in their room. After that day, I decided to build my own financial management. The first way is the avoider. I started to avoid looking at e-commerce application to stop myself from buying unnecessary stuff unless it is broken. I also compare the prices, which is more worth to buy it and affordable for myself. And the second way is the limitation. I am working with my mom at home, and every month she will transfer my salary into my bank account. I will always take note of how much money I get for my salary and set a limit for myself of how much I will save it as an emergency and for daily use. The third way is the note taker. Whenever I purchase something, I will always take note in my phone after I bought it and see whether I had crossed the limit of the budget range that I set. All of these three ways, the avoider, the limitation, and the note taker, is to manage my finance in daily life. I recommend everyone to control yourself on buying something that you have the desire to buy. Everyone has wants, and sometimes we spend way too much at it. If we could manage our finance and keep some of the money a part of our savings, we will not have any fear in any kind of emergency and situation. During this pandemic period, this is a very good example and a good lesson for everyone. Lastly, I would like to say, stay safe everyone, take care of yourself. This is my good story.
No, I've still got a lot of fire left in me.